You remember that?
That's called sun. We haven't seen that here for a while. It's been very, very gloomy. So, I was going to do two videos concerning this subject, but since we only have one day of sun, that's today, I'm going to do both videos. And what that is, winter sun goes across the horizon at a much lower altitude. So what you have to do in order to get the solar rays into your oven is you have to turn it to its winter position. There we go. Get it? And, you know, you would put the food down in here. There we go. And I'm fixing to make, what I'm going to make today is just cabbage and sausage, a quick, easy thing. Set in there. Let it simmer all day. And since I have so many trees here, I'm going to be moving this all day. And the second thing I'm going to show you is, this is the old original solivore reflector, which I haven't had any trouble with it, but they sent me a new one that is more highly polished, and it's called, good Lord, I've lost the paper. It's 87% of the sun's rays are reflected into the solar oven. So it's got a numerical number of 87, and it's anodized, polished and anodized, so the shine will stay, which, you know, this one doesn't seem not shiny, but when you compare it to that one, it's really a big difference. But like I said, I haven't had any trouble with this. And what I wanted to do, if we had more sunshine, I wanted to compare the two reflectors with a thermometer in there and see just how much of a difference it does make in the winter. Because in the winter, when the sun is at its lowest, where it crosses the horizon, is when you have to be most particular about making sure you keep it aimed well. And check it, you know, a little more frequently to aim it at the sun. All right, let me go in and get my cabbage cut up and my sausage and find a pan that'll fit, because this area here is a little less wide than this area here, which is typically the bottom. Now, this is the bottom. I think this is 8 inches. Hold on, I have a tape measure in my pocket. Yeah, 8 inches versus, I think that's 9.5 or 10, right at, yeah, 9.5. So, I'm going to leave this here for now, because we're going to have probably an hour or two right here where it's at of sunshine, and then I'm probably going to have to move this, back here somewhere. We'll see. I have sunshine all over my yard, but I also have trees, you know, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, big one, 5, and then right in front of the house on the other side of that chimney, 6, 7, 8. So I may have to pull this out into my yard, which is fine because I built a wheel cart for it. All right, let me go get my cabbage and my sausage cut up. Alright, it's only been in there for a second or two, and while I was in there cutting the cabbage up, I put this cover back on it to preheat the oven, and it was past 150 just in the few minutes it took me to cut the cabbage and sausage up. Actually, it's little smokies is what it is. I didn't cut the sausage up because the sausage is frozen, but I did have some little smokies. So, I can definitely see where that there's a difference between the old reflector and the new style reflector. And I guess this is going to be the one they ship with these new stoves from now on, is the more highly, I'm not certain of that. Maybe this is an option they offer. But if you live in an extreme northern climate, maybe this is the answer if this doesn't work for you. But basically, that's what I wanted to tell you. If you live in the northern part of the country, or any country, if you live at a higher latitude, this is how you got to set your stove. So it'll catch the lower sun as it goes across the horizon. And a friend of mine, Greg, in Michigan, and Misty Valley, I think her name is. And I believe she lives in the north too, maybe the northwest. But that's the answer if it doesn't work for you. Set in its regular position, turn it over to catch the lower rays of the sun. And you know, you do have to be a little more diligent about making sure it's aimed at the sun. But I've seen these used to cook roasts in the winter set in the snow, so I know they work. All right, I'm gonna be in my shop here behind me, and throughout the day I just come out and check this just to make sure it stays in the sun. I may have to move to the front yard here in a little while, but we'll see. Okay, it's only been about an hour and a half, and you can't ask for more than that. So that's the secret, is to turning this down low enough, I mean to flipping it over on what would normally be its backside, to catch the sun's rays. Now I'm going to turn this a little bit. You see my shadow is not quite square with the thing. So what I'm going to do is, the way I do it, is I aim this a little ahead of the sun, like 15 or 20 minutes ahead. And then I come out 15 or 20 minutes later, and an hour or so later, and re-aim it ahead again. So here's how I aim it. Look at my shadow. Not the big fat shadow there, this shadow. So the way I figure now is this, actually it's almost square with the sun now, so I'm still gonna go a little more ahead. So now I'm ahead of the sun, and actually I'm gonna pull it towards me just a little bit more. There we go. Okay, now you see the shadow is more to the left side of this. Now as the sun moves this way, my shadow will move too. And what I'm doing is I'm aiming this a little ahead of the sun, so as it moves this way, you know, for an hour, it'll get really good focused sunshine. And you know, you may not have to be that particular about the sun, but I figure in the wintertime, every little bit of attention you pay to this helps get it that much hotter. And 250 for about an hour's worth of sitting in the sun, that's pretty good. And if I can have this thing at 250 for, well, I don't know, 3 hours, 4 hours, that'll be cooked. All right, I'm working on something in my shop. Let me get back to work. I don't think you can ask for much more than that in the middle of winter. It's about 3 hours into this. I can smell it cooking. It smells really good. Probably gonna give this another hour, maybe two. Tell you what, as soon as I lose that sun over here, I'll take it out. Probably based on where that shadow is, probably got about another hour. Actually, I think I can pull this back a little bit further, so I didn't have to go far like I thought I was gonna have to. There we go. Yeah, I probably got two more hours of sun without going far right here. So see in a couple hours, we'll take that out. All right, it's been about 5 hours, and it's held 300 for at least a couple of hours. I gotta go get some pot holders.
But you absolutely, oh, look at the steam. You absolutely can cook in the winter. I don't know if you can see the steam coming out of it. I didn't even bring a... Yeah, I can't lift it up. I'll be right back. Let me get some oven mitts.
Should have stirred it. One more. Yep, that's good to know. You can use a solar oven in any season. In the winter months, you just have to turn it over on the backside. I'm gonna get a fork and give this a taste. Thanks for watching, y'all.